time of day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hakeem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all wise. The brothers and the sisters today, especially all over the world, especially here, but it's all over the world, we ask the same question. Where we go? Where are we going? We see all these differences in behaviors, differences in actions for the sake of Muslims and Islam, and for against Muslims and against Islam. And things are happening so quick and so fast, we barely get a grasp on what is going on. What is happening around the world? We hear on the news, I was listening to some groups without mentioning any names. They're heading towards, and this is an eventuality, if they can get away with it, that they want to consider Islam as not a religion. They want to consider it as a cult of some sort. And if that's the case, they would lose automatically all the rights for religion, as people who practice Islam, they have the freedom to practice religion on their own. And now once they take it out from the fact that it is a religion from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they want to consider it as a cult, and that will open up doors on the other direction. This is something that, you know, we hear on the radio, and this is the absolute extreme. And of course you're talking about the smaller stuff, about the ban or all these different things and going on around us. And the question is, what to do? What can we do? What can we do on an individual level? What can we do on the society and ummah level? What needs to be done? And the answer is that we look the best source we can find for the actions and behavior is none other than the Quran itself. The Quran in surah is so obscure, hidden, a treasure hidden amongst big treasures. It's Surah Hud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Hud talks about seven different nations, seven different people. These people are nothing but they are actually prophets. And they talk about in details their altercation with their people. And it's not between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the message is about what happened between them and their own people. Starting with Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salam in the surah, but I'm not going to recite the surah in Arabic because that would take a long time and we're really short on time. We don't have a lot of time for us to translate between both. Nuh alayhi salam, he tells his people the typical message. And he would obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not commit shirk. Very simple. The very first thing they answered back, they said, they made fun of him. They said, oh, you're nobody. Who are you? And who followed you except أَرَاذِلُ النَّاسِ, except the weak ones? Who are you? And subhanAllah, you find the Muslims today, they're actually exactly addressed like that. You are the weak ones. Who follows you? Not the rich ones, not the big ones, not the important ones, not the Western ones, not this, not that. You're the weak ones. Who followed Islam, follows Islam. And then they made fun of him. Every single time, saying, what kind of message are you coming out with? What? We gonna be punished? Who? Allah, our God, our deity is one? They made fun of him. Exactly like how Islam and Muslims being made fun of in the days of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, and many other places like today. They make fun. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us from the action and the behavior of Nuh alayhi salam what to do. First thing he did, he argued back. And he said, this is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you follow me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up for you heavens, will give you rivers, will give you wealth. The good argument, the good way to speak to others. And when they were making fun of him, and especially after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to build the ark, they used to pass by him and they used to make fun. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that when they were passing by him making fun, and he says, we are making fun of you as you are making fun of us. In other words, he did not change the path. He did not change the ways because people making fun of him. He continued on And he says, I'm making fun of you. Why? Because he was saying in the context is that you think this is all, what's it all about, this earthly life? We will all die, and the day of judgment, we find out who really making fun of who that day. Look at that meaning. And then, Nuh alayhi salam had another issue in his life. His own son. Just like all of us today. Look at our sons today. Our sons today, we push them towards deen, towards akhlaq, towards the good behavior, the good demeanor. Don't steal, don't cheat, make salah, recite Quran. And sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you have difficulty, but eventually it works. Look at Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salam, when he built the ark, and the waves started to come, and he asked his son, he says, Ya Bunayya arkab ma'ana. Oh, my son, ride with us. The message was so clear to his own son. It was not recite the Quran, it's not believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not for you to worship. All he had to do, just a simple action to ride the ark. That's it. He would have been saved. And yet, his own son, the son of a prophet, he turned away. And he says, I will go to the mountain. Say, Asimuni min al-ma. It will protect me from the water. And Nuh alayhi salam said his famous saying, it's in the Quran, La asim al-yawm. Nothing will protect us. Nothing will protect except Allah, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave rahmah at that point. Do you notice the picture here? How we all live the same way? Nuh alayhi salam dealing with his own people, how they dealt with them, they make fun of them, they say you're weak, you're nobody. What is this message that you're coming out with? And then the Muslim has to deal with his family, has to deal with his own son, the most valuable kasb, as Rasulullah talked about. And yet, out of his four sons, one of them refused even to ride with him. He says, no, I'll go to the mountain. He did not believe. And the last issue that I mentioned in the surah, how he talked to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Ya Allah, you promised me. You told me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, no, don't talk about your son. That's not a good deed. That's a bad deed, even though he is your own son. Nuh alayhi salam, istighfar, Ya Allah, forgive me. And I'm not going to speak of something that I don't know. You know and I don't. The next person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about is from another messenger, from the people of Hud. Hud alayhi salam came to the people of Ad. The people of Ad immediately denied. They said, forget it. We're not going to believe, and bring on what you're promising. Bring on the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made the same argument. All my people believe. All my people understand. And they made fun of him. They put him down, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them as well. The third one was Salih and the people of Thamud. The people of Thamud were different. The people of Thamud, they did not deny right away, but they said, you know, send us a proof. Show us the proof. And Salih alayhi salam, he says, look, if I send you the proof and you don't believe, you will be punished severely, very badly. They said, no, we will believe, send us something. So he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought a camel out of a rock. And this camel brought it in for his people to believe. And this camel was so unusual, with the condition that she would be drinking the water out of the spring of water one day, and they will drink her milk that day. And the second day they will drink the water and they cannot drink the milk. They saw the proof from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and yet they denied it, they turned away. And they told Salih, they said, if without your people, without the support you have behind you, we would have killed you. We would have stoned you. Kind of like what we see today. Without these little things that, you know, protect the Muslims today here and there as the threatening matter, they say, oh, we would have extracted you, we would have kicked you out, we would have done this to you, we would have done that to you, threatening ways. And you know what? The people of Thamud, they were destroyed. They're gone away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Salih. Like as he saved Nuh alayhi salam, as he saved the people of all the rest of them from there. Another story in the Quran of what to do. in the same surah, the people of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam, this is very unusual. This story was mentioned three times in the Quran. Three angels come to Ibrahim alayhi salam, and they tell him, "We are sent to you to inform you that we're heading out to the village where Lut alayhi salam is. We're going to destroy that village." And he immediately said, "How? How would you possibly destroy that village? And there's believers in there. There's some people who believe, some good persons who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." And the tafsir said, they looked at each other, subhanAllah, look at Ibrahim, look how he cares about the Muslims. Allahu Haleem. Look at Ibrahim. And they assured him, they said, "No, we looked at that village and we only found one family that believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will save them, but everybody else will have the punishment." That story was mentioned a few times in the Quran. And again, you got to put all these stories under the context. Who are these people? Who is Nuh alayhi salam? Who is Lut alayhi salam? Who is Ibrahim alayhi salam? Who is Salih alayhi salam? It's you. It's us. It's us when we deal with others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us an actual story of others and teaching us what to do their own actions. When Ibrahim alayhi salam was told that the punishment will come to another village down away from him, and he does not even know who these people are, he was sitting there defending them. He said, "How? How, Ya Allah, you destroy this village and there's believers in there? Look how careful he is. Look how gentle he is. Look how much he loves the believers. No matter who they are, even though they don't, he does not know who they are." And hold yourself accountable, brothers. Hold yourselves accountable. Do you really care about the other Muslims? Do you really care about what they do, even though in another village, another country, somewhere else? Or we are sitting down, stabbing the others in the back, saying, "Oh, look at these people, what they've done. Look what they do." And we're telling them, you know, that's their own fault, and they deserve what happened to them. We're sitting back, backbiting every single somebody out there. Look at Ibrahim alayhi salam, who is protecting the lives and the integrity of the Muslims in another village, somewhere else. And he's making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's arguing, he's making argument on the behalf of other Muslims with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to punish these people. And look how lightly we take it, you and I and everybody else. We sit back and say, "Oh, the people of Afghanistan, the people of Syria, the Muslims in Saudi Arabia, oh, look what they do. Oh, the people of Iraq, oh, you know, this is what they do. Or the people down the street, what they do. Or even the person that's sitting next to you, what he does, you're stabbing him in the back. And you're saying bad things about him, you have absolutely no trust in him." Look at the actions of Ibrahim alayhi salam, where he's protecting the Muslim just because of the thought he is a Muslim. Or there's a possibility of a Muslim person, he deserves to be treated with dignity and respect, and he should be protected. Lut alayhi salam. That's the other story after Ibrahim. Lut alayhi salam had a different argument with these people, kind of like what we do today. When we walk down the street, we find people cursing left and right. People are saying bad words. People doing fahsha and munkar, doing bad things. And he walked up to them and said, "How? What are you doing this for? Instead of you choosing this path, you got my daughters here for you to marry and for you to produce and have a good life. Just like what the Muslims do today, like what we should be doing today." But subhanAllah, brothers, we find the Muslims today, they're using more than three-letter words sometimes, not all the time. More than the non-believers, the non-Muslims. Now look at Lut alayhi salam, he's fighting for that dignity. The other day, brothers, I want to tell you this, and this is an obscure story. When I sit down with some of the brothers from some parts of the world, Muslims, they sit back together in a fundraiser for them to collect some money for the people of Syria. The minute sat there, guess what? The hookah was in there with them when they are collecting money for others. I say, subhanAllah. You do the munkar, you do something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want you to do. And you're doing it in the name of Islam, and you're Muslim, you're sitting there. And while they're sitting there telling jokes. A joke about this guy, a joke about this girl, a joke about this, a joke about that. And I said, what did the people of Lut do? Exactly what they've done. تَأْتُونَ فِي نَادِيكُمْ مُنْكَرٍ. They do things amongst each other that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited it from happening. At the end of the surah, after speaking about these, the actions of all these people, they're people, but they're actually us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the order. And he tells Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam, and he's actually telling us, فَاسْتَقِمْ أَنْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعْكَ. اسْتَقِمْ. Act straight. Obey the deen. You and everybody who made tawbah with you. Usually the order comes individually or collectively. This time individually first and collectively afterwards. فَاسْتَقِمْ أَنْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعْكَ وَلَا تَطْغَوْا. Do not transgress. إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. He is fully seeing of what you are doing. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا. Do not give in. Do not give in. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Do not give in to the ones who transgressed against themselves. The message was clear, brothers and sisters. The message is, when the people of all these different nations, they disobeyed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered these five or seven people, like it's us, ordering us, to stay on the path. Stay on the path. And never, never to transgress. وَلَا تَبْقَى. You notice how frustrating it gets? You notice how frustrating it was for Nuh alayhi salam, for him to be in his people for 950 years. And he's making da'wah, 950 years. Not a single time he said, you know what, let me go assassinate this guy here on top. If I kill him, maybe people will listen to me. Well, not a single time he said, you know what, let me go ahead and announce war against these people or something like that. And then, you know, the da'wah will progress better. لَا تَطْغَوْا. Do not transgress. اِسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ. Be on the straight path. And be patient. Be patient. Do not transgress. Do not cross the line. If they speak of hatred, don't hate. If they speak of violence, we have no violence in our lives. If they speak of ill feelings or ill things to be done or bad things or mischievous acts, we speak with the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we stick to it. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَلَا تَطْغَوْا. Do not transgress. The other side, وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. Do not give in. Do not change your ways to become like them. Do not be like them. Do not be like the ones who want you to leave your deen and soften your deen and make your deen not too much of a deen. They tell our women, you know what, it's okay, you're Muslim, it's okay not to wear hijab. It's okay for you to be a Muslim, but you don't have to go to the masjid every day. Just go in there, Salat al-Jum'ah, maybe when you eat Salat, that's fine. They tell you, you know what, it's okay for you women, or you know, not to wear their, you know, to hide their aura. It's okay to show whatever, it's okay to be like that. It's okay for us to go see the movies where bad actions are happening and bad words being exchanged. It's okay, it's no big deal. And we don't object. We don't stand with our deen and say that is wrong and that is right. لا تطغوا. Do not transgress and do not give in. Do not do violent things. Things or say things or have bad feelings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us not to have. And do not give in, you become like them on the other side. لا تطغوا ولا تركنوا. فاستقم كما أمرت. Be on the straight line. Right in the middle. Never give in. Look at the message there. The message is clear. And eventually, the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prevail. Just like what have all these different people. Nuh alayhi salam, Lut alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Salih alayhi salam. The people, every single somebody, he's the one who was saved and everybody was destroyed. One way or another, is the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? We don't know. When? We don't know. All what we know is that, care for yourself. Brothers, استقم كما أمرت. Stay on the straight path. Adhere to the deen. Adhere to the instructions of your deen. Recite the Quran. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ. Make salah. أَطْرَافَ اللَّيْلِ. أَطْرَافَ النَّهَارِ. Make salah every day. Do not miss your salah. Wasbir. Be patient. Be patient. Some things will be done to you. Some things will be said to you. They will make fun of you. They'll make fun of your name. They'll make fun of you, what you say. They're going to tell you things which we see even today, out in the open today. Get out of my country, kind of words. And you say, you know, they call you names, the country that you come from. And they say things to you. What do? We never get angry. We never get upset. We always stay on the path of Islam, the path of patience. We are always on the path. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتِ أَنْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ You and the ones who repented with you. We have the path, brothers. We never give in. At the same time, we never give in to their ways. We change our ways to become like that. We have our ways, the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We adhere to it. We stick to the message of the Islam. We don't change it. We don't transgress against anybody. And we don't change our ways to emulate others. We are right there on the straight path, inshallah. أقول قبلي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ولا نكفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجده وليا ولا نصيرا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أنزله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. This is a prescription for success, brothers and sisters. It's a prescription for success. The brothers who transgressed, if there is any, we don't know who they are, what they are, and we don't know what they're doing. And if anybody, any of us, thinks that he's helping the deen or helping himself by transgressing against others, Muslims or otherwise, when we hear about the bombings, we hear about the killings, we hear about things done in the masajid and sometimes in the churches, sometimes in the places of the public places, this transgression, brothers, we don't do this. This is not the way we stand. The same time when we see some of the people who gave in, they are Muslim just by name. They're Muslim by just an actual, you know, saying I am a Muslim, but they got nothing to do with Islam. They don't act like the Muslims. They dress like the non-Muslims. They walk like the non-Muslims. This is also wrong. Our path is in the middle. The straight path, the path of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. And when we hear all these different things that's going on around us, we hear about the news, the brothers, and this is another issue also. Bashiru, bashiru, wala tunafiru. Say the good word. Say something pleasant. Say something that is, you know, optimistic to others. Do not have this pessimistic look. Do not have the pessimism to overshadow your conversations against, you know, amongst your others. This would actually reflect very badly. I want to give you an example of this. 2 days ago, we were in Salat al-Isha, and we were telling the brothers to say, be vigilant, be careful. When you leave the masjid, leave in pairs, two or three or four, and that's even better, this is jama'ah. When you walk down the street, you know, come in to three or four people together, keep an eye on the masjid. When you lock the door, make sure you don't leave a single person to lock the masjid alone. To always be vigilant to see what is good for the community, what is good for yourself. Right at the end, somebody walks up, right at the end of the lecture, some brother walks up and says, yeah, there's two masajid got vandalized in Northern California, there's two guys got beaten down the street. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. The other guy walks up, he says, oh yeah, you know what, the FBI came over to my house, you know, right after I left the masjid. The third guy said, you know what, my cousin got killed down in Oklahoma. You know what happened to the rest of the people in the masjid? They walked away. They don't want to even listen to any of this anymore. They walked away from the masjid. Yeah, what did you benefit out of this? What do we benefit out of nothing, bringing nothing but pessimism? Do you think we can change the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what's going to happen? Can we change what's going to happen? There's no way to change it. So what do? We become vigilant. We look at the future. We look at what can we do to protect ourselves, to make our deen better, to make our path safer, to benefit others with what we do. Today, most of the conversation going on between Muslims, Oh, look at the Muslims got killed over here, they got hit over there, this guy this way, this guy that way. Ya akhi, when you sit there, you say, La ilaha illallah, I really don't want to come to the masjid anymore. Every time I come, I speak to some Muslim brother, I get depressed. Why? This is not the way Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. When the most toughest times of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, times may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, it is so bad. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam were in the Medina, and the Ahzab is outside. They are going in there to exterminate them. And one who said the hadith, he says, Wallahi, if I'm going to go the qada'i haja, if I'm going to go to my own private business, I probably not going to come back. That bad. Well, Rasulullah alayhi salam, what happened? What did he say? When they were digging the ditch, and in the ditch, and they're working so hard in that ditch for them to protect the Medina, and there's a huge rock in the way. And they told him, Ya Rasulullah, we're stuck. There's no way we could remove this rock. He goes in there, he carries the axe with his own hand, the pick, and he hits it and it sparks. Rasulullah says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, I have the keys for Persia in my hands. And then he hits it again, it sparks again, he says, Allahu Akbar, I can see the gates of Yemen in front of me. If he sits there, he's got to tell him, oh, we got a big rock, la ilaha illallah, we count another rock over there, and this, nobody would have won. Everybody would say, forget the ditch, let's run away, and let's just, you know, escape with our own skins. Look at the optimistic one. In the same place, in the same time, Rasulullah wasalam in the Medina, and they were under attack, and they had a treaty with some of the tribes, the Jewish tribes in the Medina, and they turned against Rasulullah wasalam, they turned against the Muslims. He sent the three emissaries. He says, find out for me. Since if you find out that they are still on their oath, advertise it. Say, Alhamdulillah, great news. And if they have violated the oath, say something to them. So they went over there and they found out that actually these guys, the Jewish nation, the tribes, they actually turned against the treaty with Rasulullah. So they went back to Rasulullah. He says, oh, they kind of said, you know, like udal, like, you know, they made a resemblance to another situation. Rasulullah, he made wudu, he said, Allahu Akbar, I have good news for you. I have good news for you. So we will conquer them, and we will win. We will do this and do that. Eventually, once the battle was won, how is it won? Only by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazab al-Ahzab wahda. He's the one who defeated all these tribes. He's the one who did his work. The Muslims inside, they could be pessimistic, or they could be optimistic. You can make something out of it, something positive, or you can make it negative. But the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prevail, like it or not, want to or not. But what we have to do is, اعقل وتوكل. Do the right thing. Follow the path. Do the right thing. Attend your masjid. Care for your masjid. Care for your society. Care for your community. And care about the fact that you are a Muslim. This is a time for action. This is a time for us to adhere to our deen. This is a time for us when we have Salat al-Isha in the masjid, we'll have as many people as we have in Salat al-Jum'ah, like now. Why not? That Salat al-Fajr, we should have 3, 4, 5 lines. And every single halaqa of ilm, we should have many people sitting, listening and learning their deen. This is the time to do this. This is the time where you get up in the middle of the night and you make 2 rak'ah. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Ya Allah, guide me. Ya Allah, be with me. Ya Allah, teach me the Quran. This is not the time for you to attack everybody else and come after me. Sometimes, ya akhi, they go after the imam. After the imam is finished, they go after him. You said and you didn't say. You did and you did not do. Subhanallah. It's not time for attack. It's not time for transgression. It's time for unity. It's time for work. It's time for action. It's time for us to be united together. If one of us made a mistake, brothers and sisters, hide it from him. It's okay, let it go. You don't go out there, you just chase him to the car and you say thanks to him. And you don't go outside or make dua to him, or you talk about him behind his back with what he said, what he did. That's not the time. It's time for us to adhere to our deen. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ. Be on the path. وَلَا تَطْغَوْا. Do not transgress. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا. Do not give in. That is the message. That is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we should be adhering to, brothers and sisters. The negativity right now, it does nothing but negativity. The violence brings nothing but violence. It's time for action the positive way, amongst each other and outside. It's time for us today to go to our neighbors, explain who we are, what we are. It's time for us to practice our deen properly. This is the time. It's time for us to do the best we can for ourselves, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah with us. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us, will protect our ummah, will protect our deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect this masjid, will protect all the masajid all over the world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with us and protect us every single step of the way. أقول قولي هذا ودعي فقول آمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب القبر وقنا عذاب الحشر وقنا عذاب الميزان. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة عين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم ربنا انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم ربنا انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين. اللهم ربنا ردنا ورد المسلمين أجمعين إلى ديننا ردا جميلا. اللهم ربنا كن معنا ولا تكن علينا وانصرنا ولا تنصر علينا يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم ربنا سدد خطانا وثبت أقدامنا. اللهم يا ربنا يا رحمن ارحمنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم ربنا اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين أجمعين شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم ربنا ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين أجمعين يا رحمن يا رحيم. وادخلنا وإياهم جنة الفردوس أجمعين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ربنا كن مع إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان يا ربنا. اللهم ربنا قوي إيماننا. اللهم يا ربنا وحد كلمتنا. اللهم ربنا